For most of us, a computer is about email, Google, and the occasional Word document. But for those with an intimate understanding of a computer's innermost workings, it is a portal into government websites, company databases, and people's lives. Hackers are now more powerful, more mysterious than ever. And while most consider their mischief cybercrime, there is another side to these internet outlaws. Allison Vushnik gives us a rare look inside a hacker's world.
We are anonymous.
Their message is blunt and unapologetic.
We are a force to be reckoned with. Anonymous has a goal that needs to be achieved. Nothing will stop us from achieving that certain goal. We will go after anyone that we feel needs to be taught a lesson.
And they mean it. This is Anonymous, a secretive, leaderless hacker collective. But this Anonymous member granted 16x9 a rare interview.
We are just as sick and tired of the corrupt, malicious system as the next person. The current democratic institutions are not only failing us, they're making our lives unbearable. They get our hopes up and tell us change is coming, then throw all our hopes and dreams in the dust.
Anonymous represents a new kind of hacker, the activist. Dramatic, political, and very public, posting their videos on YouTube. But hacking existed long before Anonymous. The explosion of the internet brought the explosion of hacking and hacker culture, with its own rules, hierarchy, and code. And there are different kinds of hacking. Some are criminal, others political, and some actually hacking for good.
The line is a really tough one to draw, but you know, hacking is anyone.
There's good hackers, there's bad hackers, there's hackers who are do what they do in order to find out vulnerabilities and weaknesses in applications and computer systems in order for us to be better protected. And then there's bad hackers who use it for, you know, making a name for themselves or just making money.
Regardless of motivation, all hacking relies on a powerful set of skills that both build and dismantle, a game of cat and mouse where the stakes have never been higher and the rules are tested, yet still undefined.
There is this battle between good and evil going on.
This is a billion-dollar plus industry in North America alone in terms of cyber crimes.
You don't really need to know anything about hacking to be highly successful.
There are different types of hackers doing different types of hacking. The most serious are cyber attacks, lifting credit card and personal information, extortion, stealing identities, and ruining lives. Then there are political hackers, attacking government websites, even more frightening, deploying a computer virus inside an Iranian nuclear facility. These are not old school bank robbers.
I mean, the biggest problem with bank robberies out there is that, you know, there's a lot of alarm bells, you have to break something, you know, people are shooting at you, where you can do a cyber attack, sit in your pajamas, drinking a coffee or a tea, and you're, you know, the world is your oyster.
And when there are crimes, companies hire Daniel Tobik and his cyber forensic firm Digital Wizard to investigate.
Sometimes the bad guys are ahead, sometimes we're ahead, right? But it's always a game.
The game played from an undisclosed location where they track down cyber criminals from all over the world.
They find a weakness in the system and they're able to penetrate. So the cost can be sometimes in the tens of thousands, but usually it's, again, depending on the size of the company, the infrastructure can go up as hundreds of thousands, and we've seen companies who spend millions of dollars to fix those kind of vulnerabilities.
Companies and governments need to fix those vulnerabilities before they happen. And that's why they come to a place like this, a hacker convention. They come here to recruit and hire, making the hacker a hot commodity.
I solve problems extremely quickly and I enjoy learning. It's my passion in life. And I think with that skill set, that would be valuable to anyone.
At conventions like these, you'll find Canadian Carsten Johansson, a hacker for hire. Carsten always liked to figure out how stuff worked and then share it. Never a rule breaker, just someone smart, creative, and capable. He's now hired by large corporations to test how secure their systems are.
I'm really used to hearing about how wonderful a company's security group is, and or their administrators. They're always the best. They're always, and there's no way you're going to get through this because we put too many controls in and blah, blah. What winds up happening is I do find a way in. It's a very common issue that there are so many vulnerabilities that are out there. It's impossible to keep on top of all of them.
Back to Anonymous, a hacker movement with a political purpose.
We are Anonymous. We are Legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.
All in the name of internet freedom, they defend breaking into secure systems, violating personal information, and bringing down massive servers.
We don't want people to be scared of us, but we also want people to take us seriously.
A message this Anonymous member tried to get across when he agreed to be interviewed by 16 by 9.
Maybe our videos are just like that. People aren't used to watching videos done by what the government calls a quote, alleged cyber terrorist group.
He's right. The U.S. Department of Homeland Security has issued warnings about Anonymous, and the FBI is tracking them. Another Anonymous member agreed to explain the movement's goals to us. This time, it's Greg Hausch, an outed Anonymous member.
I don't think there's ever an endpoint to this. I think you kind of have to get that idea of justifying the illegal things out of your head, because the idea that it's even illegal doesn't even come up. No one even cares. They're active in every country in the world. I mean, Anonymous, it could be called a group, but it's really non-existent. It's anyone who wants to use the name and wants to actually protest or do an action online under the umbrella can. You know, the skill sets are actually these days relatively easy to pick up.
In fact, there are hacking tutorials online where you can learn how to crack passwords, send a virus, or get access to systems.
I'm anonymous if I choose to be. You're anonymous if you choose to be. Anyone is.
Their actions can be illegal, and their politics push the limits. But Anonymous are turning the hacker into a force to be reckoned with. They claim to be the hidden face of the 99% who are sick and tired of their needs being ignored. Anonymous has targeted corporations, governments, banks, and in this year of the protest, joined Occupy movements around the globe. Greg says it started out as a nuisance, pranks against various websites and businesses, just to get a laugh.
Causing mayhem on the internet by randomly just, you know, messing with other websites. They were mischievous and having fun and doing whatever they wanted.
It turned serious, a form of protest using computers in a new kind of war.
At some point you just have to say, we don't care about your laws because they make no sense.
Some call it hacktivism, fighting for social justice by hitting people where it hurts most.
You have to believe that civil disobedience has caused a lot of good in this world. And where would we be without the civil disobedience that brought us, you know, women's rights to vote, blacks' rights to vote? You know, I mean, there's a common thread there you can find that, you know, the people who they've gone after have in some way, in Anonymous's mind, really deserved it.
In 2008, Greg and some friends decided to take on the Church of Scientology when the church took an unflattering video off YouTube. To Greg and other Anonymous members, that violated internet freedom.
We thought we were going to troll Scientology for a week, too, you know, online. So we made this video that we thought was very ominous and scary, and we named it the Message to Scientology.
Anonymous has therefore decided that your organization should be destroyed.
And out of nowhere, CNN's playing the video on TV, and we're like, wait a minute, what did we do?
The Church of Scientology didn't know what hit them, attacking Scientology's website, amassing an online army with massive protests on the street. Anonymous was on the move.
At that point, that was the first real gigantic acceptance of Anonymous as an idea, as a brand, as anything, that went out to the public, because all the news covered it. You know, it was everywhere. That got lots more people involved.
The church calls them a hate group, claiming they receive bomb, arson, and death threats, and providing 16 by 9 court documents showing that two other individuals were convicted and in prison for the hack and ordered to pay damages. But it didn't seem to slow Anonymous down.
When they realized with the Church of Scientology aspect that all this notoriety, because of the fact that it was a target that a lot of people agree with, that they found they actually got the support of general people, and kept hitting the news every time they said anything.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.